Welcome to Logic First. In this video, let's learn about dereferencing pointer variables. In the previous video, we learned how to declare a pointer variable. Say if there is an integer variable called a taking the value of 20, and if you want to declare a pointer for this variable, you should declare that as integer as well. Mention a star to indicate that this is a pointer and give some name for the pointer. Say if this pot is getting allocated for the variable a and the address is 5320, the value 20 will be assigned here, and for p some other memory spot will be allocated, say if it is 5336. In order to make p as a pointer for a, we have to store the address of a in the pointer p, only then it will start pointing to a. So the address of a is actually 5320. That will now be stored inside p. P now contains the address of a, which means it is pointing to the variable a. Inside a printf statement, if you try to print the variable a, whatever value it contains will be printed, right? So we will have 20 in the output. If you print and see what is there in p, it contains the address, right? 5320, so that will be printed. Say if you want the value of a, just with the help of its pointer p, what you have to do is you have to give star p. If you give star p, p has an address, right? It will go to that address and then it will fetch the value present in that address. So star p will give you the value of 20. P will just give you the address. If you give star p, it will go to the address and fetch the value present in that address. The star used here is known as the indirection operator. Instead of directly having this value with the help of the variable a, we are indirectly using the pointer to get this value. If you print ampersand a, this address 5320 will be printed. If you print ampersand p, even though p is a pointer, it is also like other variables, so it will also have a memory address. This address will be printed, 5336. Just the same example, I am writing in a different way. The variable a has the value of 20. Say the address of this variable is 5320. We have a pointer for that variable. Address of a has to be stored in the pointer, so 5320 will be stored here. So the pointer is actually pointing to this variable a. Say we have a character variable called ch and we are assigning the value of h to it, small h. A space will be allocated for the character variable in the memory. Say the address is 8700. We are storing the value of h in the character. The corresponding ASCII value will be stored in the memory. 104 is the ASCII value for small h. Characters are always converted into ASCII values when stored in memory. Say we want to have a pointer for this variable, we have to declare that as character as well, star cp, and we can directly assign the address of ch to this pointer. Say this is cp, it now has this address 8700, so it is pointing to this variable ch. The character actually needs just one byte to be stored in the memory, that's why we have assigned it like this, whereas an integer requires 4 bytes of memory space to be stored. This address just refers to one byte. For the next byte, there will be another address. So when we say 5320 is the address of the variable a, we mean that it is the starting address. Actually, this value 20 will be stored by combining all these four addresses, but we are just referring to the starting address always, just to keep things simple. 5320, 21, 22, 23, all these four addresses are now combined to store the value of 20. In memory, actually, this address values might be decreasing. In most cases, it will be like that. In a printf, if you print star p, what you will get is p has the address 5320. It will go to that address and fetches this value of 20, and that 20 will be printed here. Similarly, in this printf, for star cp, cp has the address 8700. It will go to that address and then it will fetch the value from that address. It is 104, but since we have percentage c, it will be converted as the character and printed as h. And we know that the star here is the indirection operator. It is different from the star present in the declaration statement. In declaration, star indicates that this is going to be a pointer. That's it. But anywhere else in the program, if you mention star, it is an indirection operator. It will go to the address mentioned and fetch the value from that address. Okay, now when you give star p, it is going to this address and fetching a data which is spanning across 4 bytes. And here if you mention star cp, it is going to this address and fetches the data which is just 1 byte. Both are pointers only. How does it know how many bytes of data to fetch in each of the case? How is it able to get the data correctly? It is because while declaring a pointer for this integer variable, you have to declare that pointer also as integer. Only then it will know how many bytes of data it has to fetch when you use an indirection operator like this. Similarly, while declaring a pointer for a character variable, the pointer should also be declared as a character. Only then when you use star cp like this, it will know that it is enough to bring just 1 byte of data from the memory since it is a character. Using the indirection operator star to fetch the value from the memory is known as dereferencing pointer variables. That is, when you mention star p, you are going to the address and fetching the value. That is known as dereferencing pointer variables. We know that for storing integer we need 4 bytes and for storing character we just need 1 byte. So if you ask whether this integer pointer needs 4 bytes and this character pointer needs just 1 byte, no, it's not like that. Pointers are always going to contain some addresses, so it will be of constant size, probably 4 bytes in most compilers. It doesn't matter whether it is an integer pointer or a character pointer. The pointer will always have a constant memory size allocated. We are mentioning int or char while declaring the pointer because the compiler needs to know how many bytes of data has to be fetched when we use an indirection operator like this to dereference the pointer variables. That is the only reason we are matching the types of the variable as well as the pointer, just to know how many bytes of data has to be fetched when we are using star p. By using star p, I can not only fetch but also change the value present in the memory itself. If I give star p equal to 30, then it will go to that address and changes the value present there. 20 will now be modified as 30. A is now changed as 30. So in this example now, if we print the value of A, it will be 30 in the memory. If you print what is ampersand A, the address of A is 5320, that will be printed. If you print what is P, P just has the address, right? That address will be printed. If you use star P, then it will go to that address and fetches the value there. So 30 will be printed. You can also give star of ampersand A. The address of A is this. Star means the value at that address. So the value at that address is again 30. Instead of directly giving A, it is like indirectly giving the address of A and then fetching the value at the address. Both of these are same. The star here has to be read as the value at the address. So this means the value at the address P. So the star has to be always followed by an address here, star P, because P has an address. Star of ampersand A is also valid because ampersand A is an address. But if you give star A, it is not valid at all. A contains some number 30, it is not an address, so this is invalid. I am using code blocks. I have declared a variable A and a pointer to that variable. I have declared a float pointer as well to point to this float variable. Just play around and try to print all the values. What is star P, what is star FP, what is star of ampersand A. I have just printed what is the size of this integer pointer P and what is the size of this float pointer FP. If I run this, we can see that both are of size 4, that is 4 bytes. So the pointers are always going to be of same size. It doesn't matter what data type we mention here. Pointers are always going to store some addresses. The purpose of the data type that we mention here are just to dereference the values correctly while we use the indirection operator. Thank you for listening.